Hey there, mate. Looking for some exploits? Well, you've come to the right place. I've got a little tip I can show you on how to increase your production drastically without using much more space. Now, do you see how all these apple orchards are busting their asses off to get me some apples? I've disabled all the food consumption for this little test, if you will, to more accurately measure it. Now, what I'll do is I will delete all of them. Right, actually let's even sell the cheese too. There we go. Let's build one. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna wait for a employee to show up. You're gonna press on the building, you're gonna press P for pause. You're gonna work halted and then unhalted. You're gonna unpause, and as you can see, a second worker is coming in. Can you do this multiple times? Of course you can. Pause, unpause.
Game running. Game
boom,
boom.
Game
running.
Wait until this disappears.
Game
pause again.
Game
pause. And again.
Game
pause.
Game running.
Now, as you can see, you have a fuck ton of harvesters, farmers, so to speak, bringing you apples. Now, of course, they are limited by the seasons, but once the seasons are a go, the farmers can start harvesting, and as you can see, there's no actual limit of how many apples can, so to speak, spawn. So from a single orchard you can have numerous harvests. Of course, eventually the season will end and oh well, but usually one farmer can get a single harvest off and that's basically it. Now if you have multiple farms, this effect will basically duplicate. So instead of getting an extra farmer, you'll get two extra farmers, and again and again and again. Now, some things like cheese doesn't really work, so it's a bit problematic with buildings that have animations. As you can see, there is a worker inside it, but the guy carrying it, well, once he comes back he merges with the animation again. So if you have your cheese farms really far away, it may be beneficial for you to have two farmers, one conducting the animation and the other one to bring the cheese. That is the only way to make it more efficient. Similarly, for iron, you don't really want a lot of them. Now, as you can see, quite a lot of them are bringing. As you know, there's only one per mine, right? But I have a fuck ton of them, and I only have three of them, and this increases my iron production quite drastically. Now, this once again really depends on how fast can you bring the iron back to your stockpile. Because usually if there's only one guy and there's a long way to walk, he'll just stand there and the iron will basically just accumulate. And he'll never sort of get all of it, right? So you only need a few of them as well. Well, if it's right next to your stockpile, you don't really need to abuse it. But again, the second miner, he will merge into the animation, and all you'll do is you'll lose an extra worker, an extra point of population to nothing. So this won't really work. As you can see, look at that, how many people left, right? Because if you do this trick, an extra miner who goes down will appear, and he will not duplicate the production. Similarly with woodcutters, they will bring trees twice as fast, but once he is in the animation, there's not really any point to him. Only one will be able to come out, while the other one will be able to go chop some trees. So I guess steel woodcutters is efficient in a sense, but the most efficient ones are hop farms, grain farms, apple farms. These are the best ones. Now, Hunter's Post, I'm not gonna lie, I actually have no idea. I don't usually use this one. It's not very often that you get this one in missions. Do we have any of them? Yes, we do. So we can't try it, but you can test it out. You just build it. It will work. That's what will work. What will be efficient? I don't know. Bars? Nope. Breweries? No. Bakeries? No. Mills? Mills should work, technically speaking, because you can have multiple of, well, the little boys do wait in the queue, don't they? So I guess not. Only one at a time will be able to do it. So perhaps not. Again, it all depends if there is an animation. If there's no animation, like here, there's no animation, he's just harvesting it, then you can have multiple people working the hop farms. Same goes for the grain. They'll wait for the season, they'll harvest it, and you're good to go, right? So we'll have multiple bales of hay or bales of wheat coming in. I guess the same thing. Or I guess not. Yeah, so apple farms, dairy farms not so much, hop farms, and wheat farms are the best. Now, in missions where you have very limited amount of space, put a single farm here, wait for it to get employment. Pause. Now, if you have multiples, now I just duplicated five of them. You'll get so many fucking hops. It's ridiculous. So this exploit, you don't need to take it to extremes. Now, of course, this does use up a population point, right? So you will need more population. You're not just getting these people out of thin air. You are making more use of the space that you have, which again will be very useful for missions. Again, this does work with a lot of other things, but mainly just look at them. Look at them go. Full, my lord. Oh, the stockpile full. Okay, give me one moment. That's why they stopped. See that? Look at that. Look at all that hay. Now, if they're lucky, well, I think they should be able to make it for a second harvest. No? They should be able to get back.
The granary is full, my lord.
There we go. They'll be more efficient. And look at that. Look at all these hops that are coming in. So, that's all there is to this exploit. Just pause, disable the work, enable, unpause. It'll duplicate and you're ready to roll. I really hope you enjoy this exploit. I really hope you abuse it. I'm just kidding. I try not to use this because it sort of eliminates a bit of the fun out of the game, but it's in the game. It's not a cheat. It's an exploit, of course, but it's not really a cheat. And if you want to use it, use it. Another one that it works really well with is ox tethers. So it's pretty good. It won't work with the quarry, but the ox tether is fair game. Pretty nice with the pitch rig as well. Again, it depends on the distance that the employee has to travel, but I guess you understood it by now. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. If you want to check out my other exploits, links down below in the description. I guess, have a nice day. Take care now. See you later.